Welcome back here to King Stadium. I'm Logan Hunt, along with me, joined by Kobe Solms, and we'll see how Florenco walk off under his own strength, going to get himself back into the game here at the next whistle, hopefully. Had to walk it off just a little bit and get a little bit of a breather. See the Foresters getting ready to get started again with Siena Heights. See Huntington starting out with it here. Nice play of sportsmanship there from Siena Heights. Boss run playing it long to McGowan, and off the flag going up. Should be called here for offsides. Referee just now noticing. And another really close call there from the assistant referee. And when the ball was played, I know when I looked up, it looked like Miguel had just about a step on his defender. Looked to be the right call, but of course we don't have a type of technology they have in the Olympics or World Cup or anything like that to see exactly when the ball was played. And I remember, the referees are human as well. Ball gonna be played out of bounds. Forrester's with it. So we near 20 minutes left to play. Saints on top of the Foresters, 1-0 so far. Foresters looking for their second win of the season. Only win coming to Rochester earlier on. Took that one 3-1. And Siena Heights looking for their first win of the season. Trying to get it here on the road against Huntington. Inside, Hurd is finally just clearing that out. I'm gonna get a bit of a ricochet there off of Roden, and we'll see a throw in coming for Huntington. See the foul gonna be on Rippey. Tripping up Santos there. Easy call right in front of the referee. See a substitution now coming for Siena Heights. It's going to be Luis Miguel Anya, the junior, coming out. And for him, going to be Enoch Saibu Bexson, the senior from Michigan. Get up at that. The attacking position there on the right side. Things starting to settle back down now. So the Foresters really starting to dominate play now. Siena Heights have worked together a bit of offense themselves. Again, the Foresters a little bit back on their heels. Play outside, Brown with it. Finding Mateus, nice job keeping that leg down, keeping control. See Len Souza leaving it off for Mateus. Marinka slipping. Forrester's playing it inside. Unger there to challenge. But no good. Samatsu coming out to pick it up, and it's a bit shaken up. Right hand flicking it a little bit, but should be all right. But hitting that one out of bounds. Pass broken up in the midfield there. Salinas coming back to take it away. And then Khan taking it away from him. Hardest with the stop there. Could have been dangerous for Siena Heights. Had Lintine running on that left side. Unger keeping it in, finding Miguel up front. Gonna wait for some more help here. Nice play inside by the freshman, Delin Souza, switching sides now. Short pass, Mathias gets to it first. Looking for a cutting Miguel. Franco right there. Forster still with it. No foul inside the box. Linsoza trying to maybe bait a call there. We'll see a throw-in coming for the Foresters. And a foul on Mathias. Coming back there on Bexson. He's taking his legs out.
Communication is picking up out on the field once again.
See an easy play there for Buzzard. Now Siena High starting to pick up on the fact he goes short almost every time. Rodden up there to apply some pressure. Siena High's now trying to come the other way, Rodden with it. We're trying to find Bexson, but not going to be there. Brown hitting away, now Bexson back with it. Win the move on Brown, but Brown again with stellar defense. Freshman really showing up. See a corner kick now for Siena Heights. As we near 15 minutes to play in the first half. Saints with a 1-0 lead over the Foresters. Off of a set piece, so. No, you gotta look at Mark Wilkie here. He's the one with the header earlier on in the contest. See Boston run on him, following him closely. Bexson getting his head on that one too. It's not a knife umph on it. Inside, Hurt is getting a piece of that ball there. Khan still with it. Going out wide to Bexson. Looking to play this one inside. Khan with a bad touch and Woos with the clear, and now it's a foot race. Siena Heights is going to win. Once again, Kobe, it really feels like it shifted a bit, that the Foresters kind of forced possession and held it for the majority of the first half. Now in this latter half of the second half, it feels as though Siena Heights is really maintaining possession and dictating play.
What's it going to take for the momentum to shift back to the Foresters?
Really, you got to think that the Foresters are going to be the ones to just keep possession here. You see Siena Heights really starting to up the tempo. They're starting to force more things, and they're the ones with the lead, and you think that'd be something you'd see from Huntington a bit more, but they're kind of content to sit on their heels just a bit. They have to keep the pressure up offensively. They have to put something together. You see Bexson getting an easy look here. Hurtis hitting that out. And a huge play there. So we see Hurtis going down, and now Bexson and Bosseron having some words. Buzzard very upset. We see both sides. See both sides now pushed away. We see a yellow card coming for Bexson. So he'll pick up a yellow card here. For Siena Heights. Hurt is still hurt on the ground after that clear. Looked like it could have been offsides against Siena Heights. No call though. Now we're in this situation here. Hurt is though gonna walk it off. seems to be all right. 13 minutes left in the first half, and already just a bit of controversy there. So now we'll see the referee going to talk to Coach Aldo Zid, giving him an explanation on what happened. See a couple of substitutions waiting to come in as the referee's still conversating on the sideline.
Could these fresh faces be the difference for the Foresters?
I don't know if it'll be the fresh faces or this whole situation kind of lighting a fire under the Foresters. Definitely visually upset over the last series that has occurred. See the referee gonna go talk to the clocksman. Gonna go get the official time back on the scoreboard for us. It'll be 13:25 left. So 13:25 left in the first half. Only one yellow card handed out there. Went to Sibu Bexon, the senior substitute that just came in for Siena Heights. Got a little wordy with Basaran. And after all of that, it's going to be Buzzard kicking it away for the Foresters. CNI's doing a nice job working it around until that last pass. Had a nice little triangle formulating there. It's now starting to see Mike Huntington really just relying on this long ball here. Con with it in the midfield. Flick tried there by Roden, but to no avail. Woos looking now for Salinas. Salinas going outside to Unger, making the run on the far side. He's going to be kicked out by Stalzer. And now we'll see substitutions from both sides. Gerke, Suter, and Brunus Horry all coming in. We'll see Lynn Souza, Miguel de Sosa, and Unger all take a seat. Also, Khan going to take a seat for Siena Heights. Also, Stalzer. Also, we'll see Ornelas coming in. And also, Landigan for Siena Heights, probably just for these last 12 minutes or so. Get some rest, and you see Bruno firing away, or excuse me, Theus firing away right when he gets in and shooting that over. Goal kick coming for Siena Heights. Seen Hasamatsu really struggling on those goal kicks and finally gets one to stay in the middle, Kobe. I think the Foresters could try to capitalize on that. Up front, you see the freshman Ian Billock for Siena Heights getting some good playing time after just coming into the ball game as well. A lot of substitutions on both sides now. Trying to save some energy now for the second half, getting a quick breather. Bosser and Billet going shoulder to shoulder there. We'll see a corner kick coming. And no call there.
Can they capitalize on this?
Oh, well, I guess we'll find out here. I'm going to have Lintine taking the corner. Saw last time Bexon was able to get ahead on it. Forster's really going to have to mark up. Wilkie with the hit and Buzzard with the stop. Back out to Lintien with second chance. Header by Brown. Clear there, going to come right back in. Rippey with the header though. Just like that, even on that corner, so Wilkie get a nice opportunity. It's the same man that got a head on it for a goal earlier on in this half. And again, able to go unmarked and have a free shot like that. Just unacceptable. Force is going to have to guard those corners a lot better. Buzzard almost throwing this away now, coming out and getting it. Bexson just getting a hit there, and they're going to say Buzzard that had a hit in his hands. See Buzzard and Bosseron talking on the back line. Buzzard unhappy with Bosseron there. Finally, we'll get ourselves back going here. Horse is working around the back line very well. Looking for a crease here. Step there from Siena High is going to take it away. Trying to keep it in bounds, but not going to happen. Franca putting it up wide and Hussard calling for it. Able to get to that one easily. And again, we'll see the Forsters just playing it short, going to try to work it all the way up the field. Need some movement here from the Foresters. A lot of standing around, no one really making a cut. Trying to get open. Let me see, right there, Hedden Sutter finally putting some pressure on. Trying to go one on four now. Why is he going to pull it back? Wait for some help. Finds Gerke in the middle. Putting it out. Matthias just waiting on it there. Going to win the ball back, though. Little give and go action with Bruno. Putting it in the middle to Woost. He thought about shooting. Trying to work inside. Quick feet. Getting it taken away. Curtis, though, going out wide. Nice find to Salinas. Opportunity here right before the half closes for Huntington. And a foul there. Looks like going to be on Matthäus. Him and Bexson just getting tangled. And see, we're going to stop the game here for Bexson. Looks to be a bit shaken up on the play. No call out for the trainer, though. Maxim Lake just to be tying his shoe up now. Should be getting ourselves back underway here shortly. With 6:16 remaining in the first half, Siena Heights with a 1-0 lead still over the Foresters. Off of that one set piece, Foresters couldn't quite defend that one, but then that's been playing fairly well, Kobe.
Sure. If they can't pull it out before the end of the half, what are the keys to the second half in order to get a score in?
Oh yeah, you got to think you still have to play your game. The Foresters have had some good looks and just have to buckle down defensively. And like I said, still working through the midfield.
So will the game plan change at halftime?
No, we won't see the game. We might see a few adjustments, but the game plan itself probably will not change. Just a few minor adjustments, and obviously the coaches will tell the players what they're seeing out there, and I'll make a few suggestions. We'll see a foul back there on Billick. Getting a bit too anxious there, coming up on Rippey. Is getting the run outside, still onside, playing a ball inside, almost an own goal there. Oh my goodness, ball just sliding out. It's like Forenka getting lucky there. So now we'll see Ty Sproat coming in for Marco Salinas. He'll get a quick breather. I'm sure we'll see him a bit more in the second half. Corner coming though for the Foresters, under five to play. Quick kick there from Bruno. Woos playing it inside and just too far. But I like the effort there from Ty Sproat trying to get back to that ball. Ball getting pushed back now to Buzzard as Fortune now set up this attack from the back again. Like the pressure there from the freshman Gerke running that one out all the way. Here comes Bexson. Gonna be taken out by Basaran, and easy call there for the referee. See the kick going to be taken here by Ornelas, freshman from Belding, Michigan. The lefty. Once again, probably going to try to find a head here. Or he's going to take the strike himself, and a bit far out for that, I would think, as Buzzard is almost too easy. See Gerke and Santos going down, and going to be a Forrester throw-in after that. Bruno's kick's getting caught in the air. Sproat getting his head on it, being the tallest one out there. Who's going out wide to Brown. Taking it all the way in himself, putting a slide on the back side, and just nothing there. Rippey going to hit that one out. Now we'll see substitution coming for Siena Heights. Andreas Mata, sophomore from Venezuela, going to come in. Now we see Gerke also slow to get up. Mata, though, coming in for Wilkie, the goal scorer for Siena Heights, and Gerke going to receive some attention there on the sideline with 2:24 remaining in the first half. Didn't see what happened with Gerke. We know he's been in a couple collisions in the past minute or so. See him get help to his feet and walk gingerly off the field. See Brandon Seiler coming in for him. Gerke going to head back to the bench here, get evaluated. Here comes Seiler looking to add some immediate offense for the Foresters. Woosh chipping it inside, Mata right there. Nice foot skill there from Woos, the captain. Now outside the run made by Billick. Buzzard thought about coming out, now has to retreat quickly. Now here comes Huntington the other way, under two to play in the first half. Woos looking for a pass. Going out to Seiler. And just like that, Bexson taking the ball right out from Matthias. Short pass there taken away from Rippey there. As we near a minute to play in the first half. Brown being a little more selective with his passing. Challenge there from Bruno, and no call. Calling it clean. Forster still with it, under a minute now. Ball getting caught up in the air. Matthias going to get to it here. The near side. Mata out on him. Ricocheted out. Brown going to go to the middle to Woos. A little far in front, still gets to it. Hand ball there from Bexson with 30 seconds to go. Woos kicking it anyway inside. Not going to be there. Now the Forster's going to have to retreat. Buzzard way off his line. No chip shot coming, though. And a foul there on Hurtis. Once again, one of those plays where he stops the run. So now we have 10 seconds remaining, and not quite sure Siena Heights is going to get anything off here. And that will end the first half of play with Siena Heights on top of the Huntington University Foresters 1-0. I'm Logan Hunt, and next we have Kobe Solms, and we'll be back with the second half of action when we return. moves back to kick. Inside, cleared away there by Loki. Throw in now. It'll be Hurtis with it. Practically like another corner kick if you want it to be. Hurtis can get this one inside the box. Selena's getting his head on it. Trying to turn now. It's going to be poked away from him. Now we'll see Siena Heights clear. Defense pushing up here. That's going to be offsides by Miguel. Miguel being called for offsides for, I believe, the third time now in this ball game. Starting to be a trend. Up in the air, we're going to see Brown winning the ball for the Foresters. Lonka going to go out of bounds here. Brown going to save it, and then lose it out. See Siena Heights throwing. Couple substitutions there from Siena Heights. Couple starts coming off. See Mata and also Bexon into the game again. Typical substitutions we saw in the first half. Here comes the Foresters the other way. Santos, though, making a great grab there. He get his foot on it just enough. Could have been dangerous. Long ball played up. Boston run on it. Chip shot there. Looked like a long hit from Roden and a sail over Hester's head. It was a bit off his line. Definitely not an uneducated shot by any means. If substitution's now coming, Santi's coming out. Coming in for him is going to be Ornelas. Had a little bit of fire under his belt to come in the first half. Throw in here for the Foresters. Woo's putting that one right into Khan's feet. So Siena Heights now with it. Kick going outside. Matthias coming right up and taking it. Tight quarters there. Foresters making it work so far. Salinas out wide. Those with it. Nice job here from Siena Heights defense. Pushing up, and we'll see a foul there on Ornelas. Woos looking to always get something quick if he can. Defense not set. Now going to set things up. Basaran and Brown both getting into the box for Huntington. Who's going to be looking for a head here. Salinas going up, ball alive. And Siena Heights keeping it out. Salinas being the goalkeeper there. Hasamatsu to the ball. And now we'll see a foul on Broden. taking Woost out. So again, we have similar play here. Hurt is going down in the box. Going to be clean, though. Rippey and Roden holding and pushing now. Getting a little chippy. And we'll see a foul on Roden. All gone, not going to be Siena Heights throwing. Haven't seen any substitutions yet for the Foresters in this second half. I think we'll be seeing some coming in here shortly. See Hester making the grab there for the Foresters. Hester gonna boom this one. Looking up to Hayden. Salinas now with it. Wide to Mateus. Even off for Salinas, trying to put it inside and gonna go out for a goal kick. So we'll see a substitution now coming for Siena Heights. We'll see Mata coming in. Wilkie gonna take a seat. You know, Kobe, this is around the time we mentioned about around the 20-minute marker where the Foresters have to start being wary of that. You know, you're losing 1-0 that first half goal. And this is something they're going to want to keep in mind. You might start seeing them push the tempo just a bit more. Might open things up for Siena Heights to get a counterattack and maybe put the nail in the coffin as well. See substitutions coming in for the Foresters. Unger and Seiler both coming in. Rippey going to take a seat along with Mateus. We'll see if these new legs can provide the spark needed to get the equalizer for the Foresters. Mata able to get the turn there and get to Bexson. He'll play that long and definitely too long there. Hester looking for a pass, getting it quickly out to Hurtis now. See the run being made outside. Unger up there. Ball going to be cleared away by Stalzer. Linsoza putting a move on Ornelas in the midfield. Broden getting on that one. Linsoza, though, still with it, just maneuvering around beautifully with the ball. Siler looking for some help. Going to Salinas inside. Somehow still with the ball. Ball still in. Unger going outside to Siler. Inside, and we're going to see a corner kick now for the Foresters. Substitution seems to be helping out here for Huntington. We'll see Linsoza going to be the one taking the corner. Left foot, definitely a favorable bend coming on the ball, hopefully, for the Foresters. Almost everyone in the box for him. Nice one on the backside. No one there, though. So this ball rolled out of bounds for a throw-in. And maybe just a bit too far on that back post there for Foresters to like. Now we're going to see, looks to be a water break coming for both teams. A mandatory water break here with 18-20 remaining in the game. Forester's down 1-0. We'll take a quick break here from FDN Sports, and we'll be back with the back half action of this game. Back here now at King Track and Field Stadium. Forster down 1-0 on Siena Heights. Big goal coming in the first half there by Wilkie off of a header from the set piece from Siena Heights. And the Saints so far haven't looked back on the Forsters. 0-2 on the year, but looking at their first win here against the Forsters. Kobe, what do the Forsters got to do here? Now, you mentioned past that 20-minute marker, they're going to have to start pushing. What would you recommend for the Forsters to get that goal?
For sure. The starters need to come back in relatively soon that were benched for rest.
Definitely with the starters coming in, gotta think that'll be a main thing. Wonder how much longer Coach Lawson will rest those guys. I don't think though that, you know, some of these substitutions they've really helped. Seen Unger and Seiler just come in the past few minutes, and all of a sudden the Foresters have been really pushing the ball, so the Foresters have been getting some decent looks up front. Hester hasn't been too busy on that back line for the Foresters in the second half. Siena Heights kind of staying on their heels and pretty content with just kicking these balls away, you know, clearing and resetting. And the Foresters are going to have to get one here late. They want to try to win this game. Right now, just really need to be going for the tie. Here goes Seiler on that far side. Beckerson tracking with him. And Seiler losing it out of bounds. Substitution now for Siena Heights. It's going to be Kevin Stalzer exiting the game. Coming in for him. It's going to be Brandon Gonzalez. Or excuse me, number seven. Tim Langed him. Hester Hare going in the middle to Woos. Out to Hurtis, has a step now. Quick hit there as Ornelas coming up the other way. We saw Hurtis and Silovich having some words. Referee stopping it though. We'll see a goal kick now for the Foresters.
This is their time to capitalize right here.
That touch there is, I see Miguel coming right back to the ball, taking away from Ornelas. And Sosa playing in the middle to Miguel. Now out wide to Unger, and offside's going to be called there. And another close call there, and Foresters called for offsides yet again. It says Starting to be a trend here. I believe their fifth offsides call of the game.
It's really starting to hurt them for sure.
See Hasamatsu getting ready to set up the kick. You know, taking his time off Siena Heights with the time on their side. 15 minutes in county remaining. Woos going up to Miguel now, forced with an opportunity. Once again, Santos right there to stop it. Unger with a nice move there. Inside, Beckerson getting a step, just bad first touch. Going to cross Siena Heights there. So quick, though, getting back to it. Nellis looking for a cutter inside, not going to be their hardest. Seems to be a brick wall on the defensive line for him. Here goes Seiler and Sosa working together. Out wide to Hayden. And Sosa going to need some help up front. Has a few trailers, ball going to go out. Quickly we see Force with another turnover there, and now we'll see Roden coming out, Billick in for him. The top front there for Siena Heights. Forces though winning it back here. Lermo playing it to Seiler. Selena's going to send Seiler on the far side. Mata coming back to it. Clean slide tackle there. Getting it away from Brandon Seiler. And Unger, nice job coming back to the ball there. See the long bomb here out of bounds. And there is one thing that Hasamatsu can work on is definitely those clearances. Just doesn't quite, you know, get it there on the side of his foot. Just kind of bashes it out of bounds and really lose possession there, but also staying safe when you have the 1-0 lead as we near 12 minutes to play. Salinas with it, looking for a pass, going out wide. And then Sosa. Mata with the slip there, ball still in, and Forster trying to capitalize now. Selena Stanson on the far side. Inside, Selena and Linsoza working together. Ball just taken away now. And we'll see the clearance from Mata. Osteron going to head that out of bounds. See Hurd is coming up to it. Con on him, and Forster's once again just keeping possession of the ball, just not quite able to get something working offensively. As it's been all them in the second half. Siena Heights hasn't had too many opportunities. Like I said, Hester subbing in the second half hasn't had much. And Unger with an opportunity here. Hasamatsu making a great play. Unger had the run and just jumping out to get that ball, but he is hurt. We'll see a stoppage coming there, and trainers coming out onto the field. Hasamatsu injured on the great play and what could have been possibly the tying goal for Unger and the Foresters. So we're going to take a break here. 10:55 remaining. Siena Heights up 1-0. Hasemasu, though, starting goalkeeper down for Siena Heights. I'm Logan Hine. This is FDN Sports. We're back here at King Track and Field Stadium with FDN Sports. Foresters right now down 1-0. Hasemasu shaking up on that previous play, but seems to be staying in the game and looks to be all right. Going to finish off these last 11 minutes or so. See a couple substitutions also for the Foresters. See Miguel back in the game and Ty Sproat along with him.
With the starters back in, can they capitalize in this last 11 minutes?
Foresters hopefully looking to capitalize. Hopefully those fresh legs will help out with that. Had a good opportunity on the last trip down, but like I said, Hasemasu just seems to be making plays for Siena Heights. Right now, Siena Heights can take as much time as they please. Up 1-0. Of course, you're going to have to get something working in the offensive end, whether it be from the starters or the reserves just coming in. Hester looking to go long here on the goal kick. Big boom there. Finds ahead of Salinas, now out wide to Miguel. Salinas battling against Mata. Mata just able to get the turn on him, but right back to Miguel. Forster still searching here. Billock getting the ball here, one-on-one now with Hurtis. Hester coming out. Gonna kick that out to Woost. Woost with a nice move. Strong challenge there from both sides. Theo's trying to leave it off inside, knowing they're making a run though. Hasemasu gonna take it now. Back to the corner and just waste some time. Long ball far side. Seiler coming right over. Heading it out of bounds. See a substitution now. Roden coming back in for Beckinson. Beckinson's day more than likely over. About 8 minutes left to play. Long ball down the line. Miguel in his foot on it. Salinas trying to catch up to it. Clearance not terribly strong there. Unless Siena Heights still with it. Now some numbers here for Siena Heights. Just ball played inside. Hester with it. Billick taking it down the sideline. Might just want to hold it in the corner, but instead trying to curl it back in. Go over the head now. Miguel coming. 3-on-4 for the Foresters. Miguel getting past the first defender, finding Mateus. Can give it back to Miguel. Those two just can't work together. Can't quite get something flowing there. Had good looks, just couldn't quite get the execution right. Souza doing a nice job with his body there, trying to maneuver. Solovic just getting to it first. Here comes Woos looking to make a play. Looking out wide to Unger. Cornell is taking it from Rippey. Rippey getting it right back though here. Foul going to be called there. Woos going out wide. Mateus, nice ball to him. Force just pushing up now. Mateus with the cutback. Doing too much here maybe. Needs to get it inside. Opportunity here. Going to be cleared away though. Langdon him. Now long clearance here. Under 6 minutes to play now. Siena Heights still with the 1-0 lead. Goal here would end any bid of the Foresters getting back into this one, but Siena Heights is gonna play keep away here, it looks like. Ball gonna go out, gonna be forced to throw in now. And Souza doing some fancy footwork, working it up himself now. Still with it, now losing it. Woos with a nice flick there, working with Miguel. Putting it up to Mateus. And just can't quite turn it around, gonna be a goal kick. Time starting to wind down here on the Foresters. Under 5 minutes to play. Billock going inside. Hester getting to the ground to make the save and now looking to move quickly. Going to Woos. Forrester's opportunity here in transition now. Roden bringing it back for Siena Heights. Forster's discombobulated here. Miguel de Sosa coming back to get it. See a goal kick now for Huntington. Just looking out wide, Roden right there. Nellis outside. Rippey able to get in front of it. 3 minutes left to play now. Out wide, Roden. Now Siena Heights. Now I'm giving the Forsters opportunities. Roden's going to hold it in the corner now. And lose it out of bounds. Now going to be a goal kick for Huntington. Boost again, looking out wide, big boot there. Ago, gonna have to get up to it. Mata letting it go. Gonna lose it out of bounds. Gonna be a corner kick. So near 2 minutes left to play. Could be a big opportunity now for Huntington. Inside, head on it, just missed it there. Sproat caught up on his ladder and just missing the goal wide right. Forsters might be able to mount one last ditch effort here. Nearing a minute and a half left to play. Ellis bringing it now the other way. Numbers here for Siena Heights. Shot. Hester with the save, coming back out to it. Able to pick it up. Nice save there from him. Looking up quickly to Salinas. Putting it down the line to Matthias now. Mata gets in front of it. Going to be a Siena Heights throw-in. A minute left to play.
It is definitely crunch time.
Rippey with it here for Huntington. Now Woost playing it out wide to Unger. Staying onside. Ball just floating back in here. Unger getting around. Santos putting it inside. Lenzos with the shot and just putting it over. And that might have been the last opportunity there for Huntington. And it was one of the best looks of the day for Lenzos. I had defenders collapsing on him and just was barely able to get a foot on it.
So what can the Foresters take away from this more than likely loss today?
Say not over yet here as we see Sproat getting called for a foul with 10 seconds left. And the Foresters though played tough and once again another game that was definitely winnable for them and will go down as another loss. Siena Heights is going to get their first victory of the year here, finally breaking through and getting a win over a Crossroads League opponent. The Foresters going to drop to 1-4 on the season, and you know what? It feels like another what if, Kobe, to answer your question. They know they can play with these guys, just some things don't fall your way. We'll be back with some more post game action when we return here from King Track and Field Stadium. Siena Heights coming away with this one 1-0 over the Huntington University Foresters. I'm Logan Hunt with Kobe Solms, and this is FDN Sports. back here at King's Stadium. I'm Logan Hunt, alongside me, enjoying my Kobe Soames. And Kobe, tough loss here for the Foresters. We mentioned a couple key things they could take away. I said they played hard, had some good looks here, just couldn't quite come out with a victory. What else do you think there was that the Foresters could have done differently to change the outcome of this ball game?
Sure. Honestly, they should take more breaks, more water. You can never have too much water.
Yeah, definitely something big for them to do there. Get some more water for them, and we see a lot of them hydrating now, stretching after the game, staying strong there. We'll be back, though. Foresters are going to be back in action next home game they'll have here. It's going to be Lawrence Tech on September the 17th. That'll be here at 2 o'clock, so make sure you join us for that on FDN Sports. Also, next production, we have volleyball coming up here Friday and Saturday. We'll be showing you them, and the Foresters have been doing big things there with Coach Sean Dell, looking to bounce back from a loss they had against Indiana Wesleyan earlier in the season. They're looking to come back big here, so make sure you stay tuned to FDN Sports for all your Huntington Forester sports action. For myself, Logan Hunt, and Kobe Soames, our director Brian, and Miss Emma Grace here on the camera, that's do it for us here at FDN Sports. Good night, everyone.